great and wonderful and blessed day, and we are pleased beyond belief to be able to be with you today with great reports of great things happening. We have a great group of people with us today that everybody in the world, I think, has seen. I'm almost positive.
Absolutely.
No, I think the universe.
The universe. Oh, I've just been out. I've been outclassed. Okay. Well, good morning. Paul Herring will say a very pleasant and wonderful day to you, my friend.
Hooty hoo!
That's Paul. He's a little loony. As we've all known for years. Okay. Well, folks, we're coming to you on a post-Thanksgiving program. It's a great day today, the 29th day of November. And we are blessed to be with you, as we mentioned. Good morning, audience. And we've got a program stacked. I think we're going to have some call-ins. We better, because they said they'd call. And then we also will have two wonderful guests. And they are with the outstanding organization called the Salvation Army. But don't turn away. Don't turn away. We're going to talk about a whole lot of stuff. And we're going to have an exciting program for you. International Academy of Flint, of course, we're always talking about enrollment. And we were able to enroll a few kids yet this past week. We enrolled a couple of children, and we're very pleased to do that. And I'm going to hand out today's agenda to our guests so they know what station we're on, at least. Huh?
Thank you.
Okay. Paul, here's your copy of what might happen today.
Hooty-hoo!
I think you've got to Candace as well. And speaking of Candace, she's all in orange today. Looking very fine, as always, and we're pleased to be able to...
Kind of pumpkin-y, isn't she?
She looks... Okay, we're
jumping over that one. You're on
TV. Right, okay. Hi, TV audience. It's good to see you. Thanks for joining us today. We're pleased to have you with us. Our program today will consist of some in-studio guests, and as I mentioned earlier, they are from the Salvation Army. Again, one of the clearly the most recognizable organization in the world. Clearly, folks throughout this world have noticed them, particularly that little red bucket that they have in front of them during this holiday season. And from that, of course, the Salvation Army is able to solicit funds and utilize those in every country in the world, as well as, of course, here, certainly, most certainly, in Flint and Genesee County. I don't think there's a family listening that hasn't in some way contributed to the Salvation Army or received benefits from the Salvation Army. Maybe not your immediate family, but I would think perhaps certainly your extended family. Well, let's give one more commercial for the International Academy. Open enrollment all the time. Our semester ends. Our first term ends the end of this vacation, or the beginning of the vacation time in December. Last school day is December 19th. And then our second term begins as soon as kids come back to school in January. 605,000 is the number to call the school. I want to give you a tour. Please let us show you what we have, what we offer families in the city. We already have a call in, so may we please accept that. Call Miss Candace, and it's good to see you.
Hi, somebody. How may we assist you?
Good morning.
Good morning. And who is calling?
This is Mary Sanders.
Oh, hi.
I'm volunteer in Lincoln Vale for International and Salvation Army.
Yay!
The chorus went wild. And where are you, Miss Sanders?
I am in the inside courtyard of the Daisy Pin Wing.
Okay, that's usually
thank
our
you,
spot.
Thank you. Appreciate your support. Merry Christmas.
Yeah, well, thank you. And she'll be saying that constantly as people pass her. That's how should
exactly.
We do this program for a little bit. And Mary's there with one of our students, and we'll have him give
well,
you...
Well, a couple of your students.
Oh, okay. We picked up a few. All right. Very good. Miss Sanders has rang bells for the Salvation Army probably for 5-6 years. Voluntarily, and last year she was able to work as a regular bell ringer. Now she has other employment, but she's still volunteering, and I think that's just great.
Oh, that's
she's got
beautiful.
Two knuckleheaded kids with her there that are her own. I wouldn't trade them for the world. They help us so much at school. They really do, and they help us so much in volunteering.
They're more than knuckleheads. They're heroes.
I don't know what that was.
They're more
they're
than
heroes.
Knuckleheads. They're
oh,
heroes.
They're heroes. Thank you, Mother. And then we have a young man that's volunteering to be there through our Student Life program. Mary, can you introduce him, or would
yes,
he like
I'll
to?
Let him introduce
I'd
himself.
Appreciate that. Very good.
Hold on. Hello.
Hi, Charles. Good morning to you, buddy. Would you tell people your name and your school and your grade and what you've been doing this morning?
What'd you say?
Okay.
Can you please give us your name and your grade and what you're doing for the Salvation Army this morning, sir?
My name is Charles Jenkins. I'm in the ninth grade, and I'm volunteering for the Salvation Army as a bell ringer.
And this is your first time doing that, isn't it, I believe?
Yes, sir.
Well, we've got some Salvation Army people with us here, and I'm going to let them talk to you. But you're being trained by an excellent bell ringer. She's been doing that for years, and she's a real pro. And here's Miss Lydia and Miss Joy, and they are with the Salvation Army. You folks want to say something to Charles?
Hi, Charles, and thanks so much for going out there and creating change in the community. That's just absolutely awesome that you're out there ringing a bell to make change. Awesome.
And Miss Joy?
Oh, Charles, I just want to say thank you. You are touching hearts in wonderful ways with your smile. I can hear it over the phone. But I also know that you're there, and you're just so, so special. Thank you for your giving and for yourself. Very, very much appreciated.
Charles, are you comfortable there in ring? I don't mean by way of temperature, but can you handle what we've asked you to do? You're good at it?
Yep, sir.
You got to be friendly. Always look them in the eye and say Merry Christmas. Thank you very much. God bless you. Even if they didn't give, if they just passed by, being courteous and kind to folks. They're going into a store, leaving one. They might be walking by you again, but then they might have some change or some dollars in their pocket they might want to contribute. So you're being trained by an excellent young lady and her two sons, because they've rang for us also for a number of years. So, Charles, thank you. You want to say hi to Mom and Dad? Are they listening?
Yes, sir. My mom is.
Well, tell her hi, would you?
Oh, hi.
Hi, Charles' mom.
That was creative. Okay. Miss Jenkins, thank you for allowing him to ring this morning, and we appreciate that very much, and the Army does, of course, as well. And we appreciate you sending him to our school. We're going to put him in college. That's one of our promises that we make, because we will not, ladies, by the way, graduate a student from our school unless they've been accepted by a college before high school graduation. So Charles is going to go to college if that's what he and his parents decide to do. Charles, thank you very much. We're going to move on to our rest of our program. But thank you very kindly, young man. Appreciate you.
Thanks, Charles.
Okay. Bye-bye, buddy.
Thanks, Charles,
Mom. Thank you.
Do we have another call? No, we do not. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, look, we had kind of an exciting moment here thing with Charles. Why don't you folks tell us all about what's going on this season? Many know, but they may not know the details of how important this is. Every single penny is so important to the budget to again provide services to Flint and Genesee County. And all of that money here stays here, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
If it's given here, it stays here. Okay.
Absolutely.
And then talk about our goal for the year as well. It's a sizable amount of money that we need to supply families with resources.
Exactly.
So go ahead. This is your program, my friends.
807?
Yeah, yes. Thank you so much, Art, for having us here today. It's just amazing. You don't often get an opportunity to share your story face-to-face with someone in the community who gives so much himself. So it's excellent. Your passion for children and for Genesee County is very touching and very much, much welcomed. We have a goal. Are you speechless?
No, I'm never.
Oh, okay, good. Just got to check on that
one. Yeah, okay, thank you.
$807,000 is our goal.
Oh.
That's what it takes to help Genesee County, those folks in need throughout the year.
Now, tell us what kind of needs we are meeting as an Army. The money goes towards, I know, water a little bit, and just a variety of things that occur. Describe.
That's true. It's a summer-long program for children as one, but the individuals that we can feed in a month, the families, the different programs that we have available to them through fire. If they have a fire, we can assist them with home, the place to stay. And the impact is huge. Last year, our numbers were 3,445 individuals simply came to our Christmas toy store.
Just for
Christmas.
Oh, I forgot about that. That's a great time. I've been there. It's exciting.
Yep. Go ahead. Our toy shop is where individuals who are in need of toys for their children, maybe a Christmas meal, coats. They would come. They're going to actually be able to obtain the need right there at the Salvation Army. And we do it 2 days, December the 16th and the 17th.
Now, can folks that have not kind of applied be able to come, or is it open, or is it closed? To explain the process. Is there still time to get in there for those days?
We had 2 days. Actually, we had 6 days to sign up. Once in December.
Okay.
Oh, excuse me. Once in October, and then again November. And we're actually talking about doing another one more day. But that's still in the works right now. As soon as we will know, we'll let everyone else know that what date that is and the time.
All right. Very good. And that occurs in our gym, the Salvation Army gym, and it's just loaded with
everything.
It's like a toy store, literally.
But yeah. Gotcha, just on what Joy had said last year, just for Christmas alone, over 3,400 people. That's amazing when you think of that number, just in 1 month. And then coats for Christmas last year. For the winter season, was it over 1,700? Was that correct?
Yes.
Over 1,700 children who didn't have a coat. I mean, how many times have you and I ever gone to our closet, cold, pulled out a coat, went outside? To even think that someone does not have the ability to do that. I mean, let's all think about that for 1 minute. For 1 minute, they can't go to their closet and pull out a coat to keep themselves warm.
Yeah, we, schools in general face that. We certainly do, International Academy, and we provide when we can. And the fact that you supplement that is just wonderful. It's just wonderful.
Right. Yeah. And then with the bell ringing, Charles is out there, he's ringing a bell. Ringing that bell. What's he doing? He's impacting the community. Mm-hmm. He's changing a life one ring at a time, when you think about that. Coats, food, water, heat, even shelter, those things that we can think about. We go home, turn on the lights, turn on the water, we're warm. We have coats. Many people in this community simply do not have. And one time it could be someone that we love, or it could even be ourselves. We just never know. So when we invest that time in ringing, we're truly investing in our community. In someone, we're giving them that hope that's so essential.
Now, give us our two locations for the Army, the two centers that we have. Well, they're actually three, really, including the ARC Center. Just talk about the facilities that Salvation Army has in Flint.
We have the one at Citadel on Kersley, and then we have...
It's called a Citadel. It's a church in and of itself. They have Sunday services and midweek as well, so that functions in that capacity. But in addition to that, they kind of operate all of the Genesee County Lapeer and Shiawassee program, or
just Genesee County.
Just Genesee County. Thank you. And then let's go to.
And then we have the Beecher Corps. They're on Coldwater. Now I don't know if everyone knows, but Beecher does have a food reclamation program. So every Tuesday,
they sure do.
There is a need for food. There's a vehicle there to a tool to actually obtain
that food.
Do
they just go there? Is that what you want them
they want
to
go there with valid ID,
and
they're able to show that, sign up, and then they're able to actually shop for the food that they're going to need.
They like the Citadel, as well as our school and others, we cooperate with the Eastern Michigan Food Bank, and they deliver weekly to you. We can't have it weekly, but we certainly did have it. We've given away almost 20,000 pounds. In fact, it's over 20,000 pounds in the last 8 days with our two events that we had. Yeah.
Well, we had two similar events this Wednesday, correct?
We did.
Our Thanksgiving Eve meal.
Thank you for bringing that up. That's right.
Yep. Okay. That was phenomenal. And Art and I spoke that evening briefly, but it was a good time had by all. We served over, I want to say, maybe over 275 people on that particular night.
And that's all local folks, because many of them walk there from their immediate neighborhood.
You're absolutely correct.
I know that's true.
And what was really great is that MTA was actually able to offer free transportation to the event as well, too.
Yeah. And with us as well. They cooperate with us just monstrously well.
Excellent.
Great
partners.
We had great numbers as well. We exceeded, we were right around 600 families, or 600 individuals at eight. Yeah, it was a great day at our school. Great day. Okay, Joy, you are director of development for the Salvation Army. So what are you directing? Music?
No, music of the heart.
I had a girl.
That I can direct. Actually, it's been a phenomenal experience.
Well, you're both new to these positions.
Absolutely.
So talk about the growth that you've seen thus far and the ideas that you may
want to try to employ here in the next year or two or three.
Oh, okay. We've been here 10 weeks, and we already have 5-year out. Very excited to be a part of the new strategic plan. As you know, we had a community survey that has come back and will really formulate all that we will do. The needs in Genesee County are huge, and we, the Salvation Army, are very well placed to fill those needs and to adapt to that change. We do a lot of different things in the community, and I'm very excited to know that moving forward with our advisory board, we will be able to impact even more families. The more who know what we do, how we do it, I think the more that understand that for every dollar that is donated, 85%, which is 85 cents, goes directly to the families and to the services that we put forth. So very excited to be part of an organization that truly gives all to the community.
Okay, I'm going to interrupt you only because we just have a caller. So why don't you stay on the mic as well? And let's caller, you're calling about bell ringing. Is that Isabel?
Yes. Yeah.
Hi, thank you for calling. Appreciate it. What is your question, hon?
Well, I would just like to say something about bell ringing.
Sure.
That 2 hours of bell ringing could feed 2 people for 1 month. Also, if you donate $10 to the Red Kettle, then that could feed 1 person for 1 month, and I think that that is a great thing to do.
Wow, that's good. Where did you get your facts?
Well, I read it on one of the Salvation Army.
Okay. Well, you're very knowledgeable. Thank you very much. Have you been ringing for a couple of years, or?
Well, me and my family are actually going to be ringing bells this year, so.
Okay, here in Flint?
Yes.
Okay, wow, that is so good. And you're such a bright young lady, I do presume. And that's wonderful. Isabel, that's a wonderful information you gave us. Why don't you repeat that? Because now I'm concentrating more deeply on what you said. Kindly repeat what you just mentioned about the percentages and such.
So if you ring for 1 hour, then that could feed 2 people for 1 month. Also, if you donate to the Red Kettle $10, then that would feed 1 person for 1 month.
Wow. Thank you. Yeah, she's basing that, the first statistic is based on the fact that you're volunteering, and therefore that means the Army does not have to pay for a bell ringer, and therefore that money is saved
right.
by the Army.
Correct.
And can therefore be used to service families.
Absolutely.
Okay.
The more volunteers we have, the more we're actually able to stretch that dollar so much more and actually able to meet more needs.
Okay. Isabel, thank you. Are you still there?
No, she's gone.
Okay, well, if you're listening, thank you for calling. That was such a marvelous thing that you brought up, and it helped us focus on what the value of putting a dollar or two or three, or she mentioned 10, into a bucket.
Well,
and that's just marvelous.
That's my daughter's. I have to tell you that.
Ah.
And how it came about is that her friends go and they get slushies every week. It's what they do, okay?
Okay.
They love slushies, and they have different flavored slushies, and it's a thing to do. And she was reading the pamphlet, and she says, so she's really, she's for $10, you could feed a person for a month? And I said, absolutely. So she said, you know what? She goes, I probably would spend $10 from, was it November 14th until December 24th?
Right.
So she added it up. She goes, that's $10. She goes, I don't really need a slushie. She goes, I want it. She goes, I don't really need it. So she says, you know what? She goes, I'm going to give that up and put it in the kettle. Because somebody actually does need
Oh, what a great, great, you've done well with her. That's marvelous. Yeah.
But, you know, it's just phenomenal that it takes a child, sometimes a child to actually be that spark.
Okay. We might be getting another call. I just heard a little beep there.
Okay.
No, we interrupted you, and
go
I don't
ahead.
Know
oh,
if you can
okay.
remember where you were at, but I mean, you're in Flint. I know you got that figured out.
Oh, yeah,
but, but in your
born and raised, actually, just
so
outside.
Take it. No continue, if you wouldn't mind, on whatever else you'd like to talk about. That's great.
Well, what I'd really like to say is that when you put your money into that kettle, and if you just can envision someone you saw on the street and your ability to impact someone's life that you don't know, the tinkling and or the folding of your money as you put it in the bucket, you can take that away And it's such an amazing feeling that wherever you look, if you see someone in need, that you've done that. Mm-hmm. You've helped them. Mm-hmm. With $10, you've fed that person for a month. Or for $25, you've purchased a coat. So it's just a wonderful opportunity to build on the future of your neighbors right here in your own community. It's very vitally important.
Okay, we just got another caller, and it's a man, I believe, and he would like those numbers repeated. Apparently that impacted his train of thought. So yeah.
Oh, okay,
whoever
perfect.
Knows it best, go right ahead.
Okay, yeah. So Isabella has let you know, and I believe, gentle, that your name is Kurt.
Yes.
If I can, say, hi, Kurt, that's what my note says. Okay, I can't see you, but I can read you. And basically what Isabella had to say is that if you rang the bell for 1 hour, that helps to feed two people for a month. That's a $20 value. But if you give $10, which is what she did in giving up her slushies, that will feed one person for a month. So the impact of those dollars, the $10 or the 1 hour of time, mm-hmm. is huge, because you don't really pay attention to time, but you seem to have lots of it. And the money, if you just envision what I said, that one person is going to be fed for a whole month for that $10, mm-hmm. it becomes a part of everything that you are.
And thank you for, young man, I guess, for reiterating that question. We appreciate that very much. And you know, I was ringing in the mall once, a gentleman walked by and said, I only got a couple of pennies. I said, please put those pennies in.
Exactly.
It really does count. And he said, okay, I will. And he just did have just a little handful of change. Mm-hmm. But every single penny counts. And I've been in the count room when you I've been in there. I've been counting and unfolding bills and all that stuff for you. And you do count every single penny.
Every bit of change creates change. You put change in and you get change out. I mean, that's just phenomenal.
And the change that comes out is people's lives.
Exactly.
Is that what you're indicating? Yeah.
I had a young lady email me recently, and they do a tradition of actually ringing bells. When they were little, mom and dad used to take them out, they would ring their bells, okay? Mm-hmm. So now what's transpired is that mom and dad come back to the area. They no longer live here. Brother and sister come back. The kids come, and so every Christmas Eve, they pick a store for 2 hours. They go out there, they sing their Christmas songs, and they shake their bells, because their dad always taught them, and she actually passes on to her children, mm-hmm. and his grandchildren, that Christmas is more than about receiving, it's about giving.
Giving, for sure.
About mm-hmm. giving.
Yeah. And the Bible, of course, speaks to raise a child, in it when they are young, and they will continue in that area. It's not the perfect word for word, but I think that's the concept behind it.
Right.
Folks, thank you for listening today. We've got several more minutes, just don't want you to go away, but I need to mention something about International Academy. Got to give you our phone number to call, 600-5000. Please do call us. We would love to give you a tour of our building. I take pride in that, to show you what it is we do. We're going to introduce you to teachers and administrators. Kids are in the hall. We're going to stop them and say, hey, I got a guest. I want you to, maybe they have a question you would like to ask those kids. And we do that all the time. We have nothing to hide. We're very open about what we do there and how we do it. And our best salespeople are those little guys walking the halls,
exactly.
And big guys walking the halls. Some are way bigger than me, but we'll stop anybody and chat with them, because I think they're reasonably pleased with what we have to offer there. So 600, 5,000, now would be a good time to consider enrolling, because our term ends the last day of this school year, which is this year's school year, which is December 19th. We'll start a new term in January, and that would be a great time if you are considering enrolling your child in another school for whatever myriad of reasons that could occur. We would welcome the opportunity to talk with you. And then, of course, keep in mind, we do have that diagnostic test that we offer in math and English, so that we can place your child in the grade in which they will succeed. We don't do automatic social promotion there. You got to earn your promotion, and you do that by testing. And we test every single week, mm-hmm. on what they learned the previous week, so we always know where they're at. Perfect. It's a pretty good plan. It's a pretty good plan.
It's phenomenal. I was there when you showed me.
Oh,
that.
Sure
that was
did. You did drop
yeah,
in.
That
thank
was
you.
Amazing.
So you saw our exam mm-hmm. hall, didn't you?
I yeah. sure did. Okay. All the kids getting tested.
Yep. Very good. You got to do it. You got mm-hmm. it measures their progress, but also it checks on something else, instructional effectiveness.
Exactly.
So we got
right.
it on both ends. Got to watch
absolutely.
Those teachers, okay? And I say that we're very kind of proud of what our teachers do, and tend to have mentoring their kids all the time and tutoring. But you just it's a good way to, we have to stay totally accountable, every single person, every single day, okay? All right, Salvation Army, I'm going to go out here right after we this program.
Okay.
I've got one stop, and then I'll go out, and I'm ringing this afternoon
oh,
as
excellent.
Well.
Oh, excellent. Where will you be?
Same place that they are, so which is the Genesee Valley Mall, indoors, where JCPenney meets the hallway
excellent.
Inside. Okay. And we've got a bunch of folks that will be ringing throughout the day. We ring for an hour and a half.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the time, I used to have it ring every 2 hours, but that way we can get more people involved if we
oh,
ring an
wonderful.
Hour and a half. And then it's sometimes, you know, 2 hours is a little lengthy for
yeah, exactly.
some kids, especially
yeah.
if the shopping calls.
There you go. Yeah.
And speaking of getting people involved, if anyone out there is interested in actually becoming a volunteer bell ringer, please give us a call at 810-600-4497, 810-600-4497.
Perfect. Very good. Now you have
absolutely.
a whole volunteer recruiter. Well, actually, it's you.
Yes.
Is that your
me.
Actual number? But there's someone
that's
that
my
actually,
direct. That's my direct line.
But then you probably have someone else that actually places folks on schedules, or is
that
you
too? That
would
be me as well.
Oh, you doing it all?
That would be it.
Yes,
but please
is.
Call. Please do call
yes.
again. That 1 hour, that 60 minutes could actually yes. is going to impact. It's going to give
yeah.
hope. To someone in the community.
Okay.
It could be a loved one, a neighbor, a friend. You never
okay.
know.
Well, I'll be there this afternoon. I think I close out this evening as well. We were a little short on kids, so I've
2 minutes.
Been out
there, oh, there
for quite
go.
A while. And then we'll come on out. Tell us you heard the radio program, if you would. And if you do that, I'll give you a discount gift.
There you go.
You won't have to give as much.
1 minute.
Candace, thank you for allowing us the privilege of your radio station today. Give Sammy Jordan our very, very best. Paul Herring, it is always great to see you.
Hootie hoo!
You.
I love that.
You guys got to help me say this. But in advance of that, I was told today, we had a Thanksgiving dinner, some viewer called in and said, my, you look dapper. And I think he said dapper. He might have said dopey.
Oh.
But I'm not sure. But anyway, in advance of that, we're going to celebrate the letter D, and we're going to do that in this fashion. We've got to do it really quick.
Okay.
We say, I'll get right to it. Are you demonstrably dipping dusty, dry, docile ducks to doggedly discover dozens of diapers dangling dangerously in damp dynamite? Deciding if Daffy deputies have deflating devices devoutly dedicated to depressed but dynamic discus-throwing deacons? Deckedly dressed like dimpled dragons, deluge in the dichotomy of delightful dinners, or documenting domesticated druids at dawn, then look at somebody and say,
woo-wee!
That is some kind of school! Bye, everybody!